Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. In today's video, I want to take you behind the scenes to create a tab view in SwiftUI. If you are interested in building out this project with a lot of animations, then make sure to keep on watching. Hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. Alrighty, let's take a look at the demo project that we are going to build out today and learn about TabView. Okay, this is the demo project that I have just set up for you. And as you can see, it has four tabs down at the bottom. It starts with the store, but here you can see that we have our apps. And take a look at this awesome animation that you can write on your own, or just take a look at the link in the description to find out where all of this GitHub repository lies. Okay, let's move forward to About Us and some awesome animations too here, if you want to take a look at it. Of course, there is an animations, SwiftUI animations tutorial on the channel, so don't miss that either. Let's take a look at the blog, and if I click on here, it comes up real nice. And if I just click on it again, it's coming back. So awesome animations, but in this tutorial, we are going to focus on the tab view. So let's just stop this and start with our demo project. And it has a content view and all of these constants, blog view, store view, and so on that we are going to add. So first things first, let's add in here our tab view. Tab view, there we go. And inside our tab view, let's add our first view, and that is our apps view. Okay, and that will be a tab item. And inside here, we are going to add our tab item views, and that is an image. Let's see, image, and that will be of system. There we go, system name, and we are going to use our constants for our system name, and that is gamecontroller.fill, person.fill, and that is added into the constants, so we may omit any typos. So sys constants, tabbar image name, and tabbar 0. So underneath the image, we are going to add our text here. And it will contain, again, pretty simple, our constants dot tabbar text dot and the tabbar 0. Okay, now let's add in here, while we are at it, a tag. There we go. And the tag should be 0 for now. Okay, let's build and run and see what we have here. We should see the apps view basically inside our tab view. There you have it. We have our game controller and the text apps, and here we have Rebeloper messages. Okay, now what we still want to add in here is our assets. So I'll just quickly go over that and add them in here. Let me just jump to this definition, show in Finder. Okay, you won't have to add any of these, but I will just add them real quick here. Great. Let's build and run again. And we should see right now our apps view. There we go. Looking awesome. Now let's add all of our other views. So I'm just going to copy and paste this, so it will be quicker. And once I have this, hit Command A to select everything and Control I to ident everything to its place. And instead of this apps view, let's add in About Us view. And the third one is the blog view. There we go. And finally, the store view. Okay, let's select the image names. 1, 2, and 3, and finally the text under those images, 1, 2, and 3. Now, as you can see, we have the tags, so we have to change those tags to 1, 2, and 3. And let's just build and run and see if all of this is okay. And after that, we are just going to set up our tags, because as you can see now in the app starts with the first one, apps. So the apps view. Let's take a look at the about us, the blog, the store. All is okay. Okay, one final thing that I see here is I want to set the images font. So font, and let's set this to, let's say, large title. Okay, I'm just going to copy all of this for the image. There we go. Looks much better in my opinion. Let's indent everything, and great. Now all we have to do here is set a state for our, a state variable for our text. So add state var and selected equals, and let's select 3. Okay, and now that we have this as the state selected in the tab view, let's add in here selected. Let's just wait for auto completion. Selection, there we go, and selected. There we go. Okay, let's add a dollar sign there. Awesome. Now let's build and run, and we should see the store view come up as the first selected view in our tab view. Awesome. There we go. A little bit too for our large title. Let me just remove this to title or whatever you would like. Okay, finally, I am going to show you how to tint the tab bar color. Okay, and all you have to do is just select the curly brackets that closes the tab view, and add in here accent color, and let's have here color.red. Okay, let's build and run one more time and see how that looks like. Okay, everything is red as it's supposed to be. And finally, I'm just going to add this tab bar, so-called tab bar, tint color, not the icons, the accent color, but the tint color. And that is a pretty UI kit-like, but let me just go in here and type in init, two curly braces, and UI tab bar appearance background color equals UI color dot, and I will just use maybe purple. Let's see how that looks like. Let's build and run and see all of the changes. Okay, and let's just fix this. There we go. And build and run. Okay, as you can see, it has a purple tint. Well, not what you might expect from it, but you know this trick as well. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video about creating tab views. Now, speaking of tab view, I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video, I'm actually gonna film everything about Geometry Reader in SwiftUI. If you are interested, make sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, while you wait, make sure to take a look also at these two videos that I have over here. I talk a lot about iOS development, SwiftUI, and how to code smarter. So make sure to check out these videos as well. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.